You're a responsible employer. You've got safety policies for lots of things. Wearing protective gear, workstation ergonomics, material handling, even lifting. But what about driving? Yes, driving. Most workers drive as part of their job, even if that means they're just going across town for supplies. If they're involved in a crash on company time, it could result in serious injury or even death. And you could be found liable. Yes, you. Everything okay? Now you can see why driving is an important part of any workplace safety plan, as such policies require three things. Commitment from company leadership. Like any policy, there must be support for driving safety. Policies should be clear and unequivocal, and they should include disciplinary actions if rules are broken. As part of your policy, make sure your employees sign an agreement to drive safely and follow all transportation laws. Every safe driving policy should cover some specific areas. First, make seat belts mandatory. Not recommended, not encouraged, mandatory for every person in the vehicle on every trip for company business of any kind. Each year in Montana, more than 1,000 people are killed or seriously injured in car crashes. 70% of them are not properly buckled in. Seat belts save lives, and they could well save the life of you and your employee too. Second, create policies around drinking and driving. We know having dinner and wine with a client can be part of the job, right? Yet, if your employee is in an accident after drinking at a work function or on company time, your company could be liable. Companies can address this issue in one of two ways. A zero-tolerance DUI policy clearly outlines that if an employee is convicted for DUI while driving for work, he or she will be terminated. And you should also recommend that they arrange for a cab, designate a driver, or simply not drink when on company business. A zero-tolerance alcohol policy prohibits drinking alcohol on company time, including breaks and on-call periods, whether you're on company property or not. As a work comp insurer, we recommend the stronger no drinking policy to protect you and your employees. But what's most important is to get a commitment from employees that they won't drive under the influence. The third critical element to include is limiting distractions. Activities such as texting, talking on the phone, jotting notes, eating, or reaching increase the odds of being in a crash by 2, 3, even 9 times. That's because there are 3 basic reaction components to driving that can be affected by distractions. The time it takes the driver to perceive a situation, the time it takes to act on that information, and the time it takes the vehicle to complete the response. Expressly prohibit cell phone use, eating, and other distractions while driving, and you could save your employee, yourself, and who knows who else. Phew. So let's recap. A good workplace driving policy includes strict guidelines for wearing seat belts, obeying traffic laws, drinking and driving, cell phone use, and other distractions. And it requires commitment. Commitment from leadership and from your employees. Do that and you'll be started down the road toward a safer workplace, even when that workplace has 4 wheels. For sample policies and plan language, call Montana State Fund.